The Red Death, a giant stalker-class dragon, a commanding queen of Dragon Island, seen bending wills of other dragons for her own malicious and greedy needs. The Red Death is truly a monster, and there's been a considerable divide on whether or not the dragon is an alpha. Some claim she is, such as the Wiki, while others argue she's not.
Hey alphas, get it? I myself, my four phases, will be evaluating the pros and cons of supporting this theory, so let's get into it.
When listening closely to specific scenes, we notice that the sounds emitted by the Red Death are similar to those of other dragons with definite will and control like the Bewilderbeast. This similarity in vocal cues suggests the existence of a hierarchy and a ruler at top. The fact that no dragon challenged the Red Death until the climax of the film supports the theory that she has the ability to transmit sub-homing vocal signals, according to the Wiki, to control dragons within her radius, similar to how Valkyrs and Dragos but Wildebeests exert control, albeit to a lesser extent.
However, it's possible to dismiss this theory by acknowledging that one of the Red Death's primary forms of control stems from the fear smaller dragons have of her.
While she has been secretly responsible for centuries of human and dragon conflict in Burke, her commanding presence and menacing reputation instilled fear in other dragons, leading them to obey her will and commands over the centuries. This fear factor may explain their apparent control she possesses rather than being a natural alpha. Although the Red Death's range of command may be more limited compared to the Bewilderbeast, it still suggests a possibility that she could be an alpha. Dragons near Burke obeyed her and weren't influenced by Falka's Bewilderbeast.
Looking at the race of the edge map,
we can see that Dragon Island, the Red Death's residence, is much closer to Burke than Falka's Bewilderbeast, inferring that the Red Death was an alpha dragon in the specific area of the archipelago. This supports the idea that more than one alpha can exist coherently. In the Hidden World, Toothless the Alpha gains control over all dragons, not just those from Burke, except for the drug ones like them Death Grippers. This showcases that alphas and dragons in how the Draenei Dragon universe might have a biological component such as smell or sound that causes other dragons to recognize another as the alpha. Toothless's instant acceptance by all dragons without challenge or disobedience suggests that there may be a limit to the extent and radius of an alpha's power. As meeting new dragons grows the group that you'll have to control, so an alpha's presence must be seen, smelled, or heard for recognition. Another contributing factor to the Red Death alpha theory is that any dragon can become an alpha, even a terrible terror, given the right circumstances, according to the directors and through the movie lore. While species like the Bewilderbeast are naturally born alphas, it is possible that the Red Death could be one as well. Her ability to emit these signals and her acceptance as a queen by other dragons might indicate a natural occurrence of alpha status, albeit weaker than that of the Bewilderbeast, as mentioned before. In How to Train Your Dragon 2, Valka explains,
"Every nest has its queen, but this is the king of all dragons."
Suggesting that being the queen of a nest doesn't classify a dragon as an alpha. Given that the Red Death is referred to as a queen in the first movie, it suggests she may not be an alpha after all, as there seems to be a distinction between these titles. Evaluating the evidence, it becomes complex to definitively label the Red Death as an alpha. While there are pros supporting the theory, such as her vocal control and limited command range, suggesting alpha status, there are also cons, including her fear-based control and the distinction between a queen and alpha. Ultimately, it remains uncertain if the Red Death possesses alpha status in the How to Train Your Dragon universe. Let me know your thoughts on whether the Red Death is an alpha in the comments below. I'm currently working on the classes evaluation video you all voted for in the community poll, so stay tuned for that, and leave down below which class you want me to evaluate first. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to subscribe and turn on post notifications to never miss a video. I also have a Patreon that you can check out to support me and the content I create. It's entirely optional, but any support is appreciated.
Thanks for watching, and as always, I'm My Four Phases, and I'll catch you legends later. Goodbye.